Qu'elle fait, nous déclarer que building ça, il est ouvert pour utilisation pour la gloire de Dieu.
He has been a wonderful brother to work with. And these two men have made this church possible. So I'm thankful for the invitation that they gave us to come alongside and partner with you. And we look forward to coming back. 2 years ago at Easter, I preached in the blue tent. 1 year ago at Easter, I preached in the white tent. And all of those times, I was looking forward to this event. Right after Christmas, I was here to make preparations for this. And I said to you at this time, finally the time is
come.
The fullness of time
is come.
And finally the
completeness of the time.
And I said we would come with a group of men. Men that have earned the reputation as the miracle men. Not because they're supernatural, but because they work with passion. And they came down 2 days late because of the snowstorm. And so we were 2 days late starting. And I said to you that we would build an entire church in 1 week. Some of you looked at me and I don't think so. That's impossible. But a couple of days ago, in not 8 days or 7 days, but in 5 days, this whole church was built. And it was built to the glory. glory of God.
Et ça, c'est pour la gloire de Dieu.
And we want you to know we do not boast in ourselves.
Non, 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 non.
Paul said, let him who boasts, boasts in the Lord.
Paul dit, vous t'appelez loin, c'est pour faire loin, j'en mon Dieu.
Paul said, God forbid that I should boast in anything except the cross.
Paul dit, si c'est la croix, ça comme Jésus-Christ est mort pour moi, c'est la croix.
That's why we have put the cross there.
C'est ça que nous décidons de mettre en croix.
Because Christianity is about the cross.
Tu aimes dire aux chrétiens, c'est parce que Christ est mort pour nous, son croix.
But it's an empty cross.
Mais c'est un croix qui vit, c'est un croix qui m'en mout.
Jesus is not on the cross.
Jésus passe au croix mort.
Jesus Christ is resurrected. And so we boast in the empty cross. That assures us our salvation is complete. And so we are so thankful for this day. Someone said that it was like this church came down from heaven. And it did come down from heaven. It came from the heart of God to the heart of this man, to my heart, to the heart of 28 men, and it was built to the glory of God. Let me share with you very quickly the importance not only of this church, but the field in the back. Paul said this, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 9. He said, we are God's fellow workers. We are partners with God. So we want you to remember that we didn't build this church. This is not the Blanc church. This is not the American church. This is the church that we built together, Haitians and Americans. We partnered together. And while we had 28 men here, every day from early morning to late at night, Pastor Marcion, members of the church, were here sweating and working with
us.
And so it was something we did together. So it's not our church. It's your church. We are partners together with God. But then Paul goes on to say this. He said, you are God's field and God's building. Two things. God's field and God's building. Now, why did God call my people a field? In Isaiah chapter 5. God said, my people are the garden of my delight. God started man in a garden. The Bible said that next to creation, God is a gardener. God planted a garden each
day.
So if God was a gardener, you need to be a gardener. And he said, my people are the garden of my delight. And so we have planted a garden here to remind us that we are the garden of God's delight, that he has planted in us the seed of eternal life. And around the garden we have planted trees. Over on this side of the church there's a row of Haitian cedars. They are to remind us of the cedars of Lebanon. God said, my people will grow like the cedars of Lebanon. So the next time I come, those cedars will be much taller. They will have grown. But more importantly, you will have grown. God's people are like the cedars of Lebanon. But back behind the church, We not only have cedars, we have Haitian oaks. The oak tree is one of the strongest trees. In Isaiah 61, God said, my people are a planting of the Lord. They are like oaks of righteousness. So you are to be not only a cedar of Lebanon, you are to be an oak tree, an oak of righteousness, declaring that God is a righteous God. God is a good God. And so trees in the Bible are very significant. A garden in the Bible is very significant. And after the service, when Pastor Pierre has to run to the next service, many of us are going to go to the garden, and we're going to dedicate the garden, because in God's sight, that garden is just as important as His church, because it is to remind us that He started in a garden. Place man in a garden. So we're going to go back and dedicate the garden. So God said, my people are my garden. But not only are we God's garden, God's field. Paul said, you are the building of God. This is a beautiful building. But please do not call it the church. This building is not the church. A building can never be the church. You are the church. Right now the church is meeting in this building. So Paul said, you are God's building. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And so we don't go to a building and call it the church. We go to the building and make it the church by being there and worshiping there, by praising God there. And so I want you to remember, you are God's garden and you are the building that God dwells in. So we thank God for the building. But Jesus didn't die for buildings. And remember this. Before God had the tabernacle built, before God had the temple built, before God had synagogues built, before God had churches built, He built a garden. And the Bible said that one day we will all go to the garden of eternity. So I want you to remember that this garden is just as important as the temple. And when I come back, I don't want to see a weed in the garden, because weeds are symbols of the evil one, the devil, who comes to sow the weeds into God's field. The wise man of Proverbs said this: I walked by the garden or by the field of the sluggard, the lazy man. And he said, the walls were falling down. And the weeds had taken over. Don't be like the foolish man. The Bible says that he who takes gardening seriously will not go hungry. God is the greatest garden of all. Jesus said, I am the vine, my Father is the vine dresser. So we've dedicated the building. After the benediction, we're going to dedicate the garden. Because Paul said, we are God's field. We are the garden of his delight. He doesn't like weeds in his garden. He wants his garden to be fruitful and fragrant. And he wants his church to be filled with the people of God. So thank you for the privilege of being here. And being good partners together. And taking care of the trees. That remind us of the trees of life. And by eating and living from those trees. We can grow like the cedar of Lebanon. We can be like oaks of righteousness. So that all over Onaville. This will be a place of strength. This will be a place of beauty. This will be a place of cleanliness. This will be a place that will bring glory to God. That is well eternal.